slogan was, oh, sorry, see? Those little cobwebs popping up for you. Every year, our logo features a mythical creature embodying the spirit of a tagline and our collective, well, mood regarding the current events. Our visual metaphors are about metamorphosis, overcoming adversity, emerging stronger. In 2019, the Rising Phoenix became our main crest, which we consistently use as our brand throughout our organization. In 2020, we had an abstract butterfly with feminine and celebratory cultural vibe. In 2021, as the pandemic wore on, an asymmetrical progression of origami cranes was used. It reflected a feeling of longing, impermanence, and optimism. This year, it's time to stop isolating and start acting. It's the year of the tiger, and we're coming out again, and it's time to take the initiative, to help build a more inclusive InfoSec industry. The Jungle Cats represent our diverse community, inspiring us to come forward, to take what's ours. We are rare. We are fearsome hunters and fiercely protective of one another. And we are all stronger together. Our discussions will focus on impactful ways, both large and small, that each of us can take to advance our information security, diversity initiatives, ourselves, both personally and professionally. We hope that over the course of our event, each one of you finds new things to spark your interest, your passion, your creativity, find new pathways into and throughout your information security career. For some of those, security may be a job. It may be a hobby. It may be a passion. We are encouraging you to take the initiative, but we don't want you to limit it to just focusing on the professional aspect. Make new friends in our networking areas. Find a new hobby in our hands-on labs that we have. Find something that sparks your interest. Here is a lovely map of where we are. We are currently in Trap 1. We did convert one of the restrooms into a gender-neutral bathroom. There are signs outside and inside the rooms to help identify as you walk the hallways as to where things are. We will have two breaks for both days. Coffee will be served during the breaks in the registration area where you picked up your badge and checked in this morning. So you'll have coffee there. And you can stop by, grab coffee, meet new people. We encourage you all to use our networking room at that time. And the networking room is literally the straight shot at the end of the hall for us. You can take your coffee outside into the pool area over here. If you needed a mask break to kind of get a breather, go ahead and take it out there. But please remember to put it back on once you get inside, because masks are required to attend our conference. Networking, as I mentioned, we have networking meetups in the room, straight into the hall during our breaks, because we have our first break from 10:30 to 11 each day. And our second one from 3:30 to 4. And these are all in Pacific time for those who are in virtual land. During these breaks, head on over there. We're hosting that new space where attendees can network, here can meet new people, interact with new people, sponsors, you know, basically expand your network. There will be an online room for this and an in-person room. So our hybrid people, don't worry, you're not being left out. Unfortunately, they are not tied together, so it'll be an in-person and then a virtual one. All right, we will also have a 1-hour lunch each day. There is a grab-and-go lunch place as well as Starbucks. You can go ahead and purchase food down there and, again, take it out to the pool area if you need a mask break, to kind of have your break out there. But, again, please remember that you need to put your mask back on. For our Discord, if you need to report, say, a code of conduct violation or a general support question, head on over to the channel hashtag submit a ticket under attendees. You'll see what pops up on the screen over here. You'll have three options of general support, role request, or report a code of conduct violation. Click on one of these three options, and a ticket will be generated for you. You can fill it out, and it will open a ticket with our administrative and Discord moderators, and they will take care of any concerns you have. For those of you who are in person, if you need to have any questions, report a code of conduct violation, or just kind of have any general kind of request, there's a bunch of us volunteers running around that you can see. They're in a red shirt, volunteer across the back. It looks like the shirt I am wearing. Come and find us, ask us. We'll be able to help you out. If you cannot locate one of us, we have a staff room, which is to the left of registration where you checked in this morning. So we'll be able, that should be a hive as well if you can't find us running the hallways. Yes, thank you. And we also have an email address of conduct@dianainitiative.org. If you would prefer to submit something that way, that will be notifying our code of conduct team. Thank you. All right. As stated before, masks are required to attend our conference. We do give the speakers the option to remove their mask during their talk if they so choose. But outside of that, the masks are required at all times. If you are feeling unwell, please stay in your room. Even if it's not COVID, we still don't want to pass around the con crud. So, and if you need a test, and you actually are staying in the Westin Hotel, please email covid@dianainitiative.org. We can get one delivered to your room, so you don't have to leave and risk exposure. Now, if you do test positive at the event or after the event for COVID, we want to know. So please email us at covid@dianainitiative.org. We won't share your name, but please tell us where your rooms that you went to, the traps, the villages, as best you can remember. Because we want to make sure that we send out to everyone and notify everyone through social media. If we have someone that pops positive, we want to let everyone know. If you're in these areas, please go test yourselves. We will also be keeping statistics of after the fact as well. I want to thank our sponsors, lovely, lovely list of individuals, of companies. Without them, we honestly could not be here today, as well as offering our in-person as a hybrid event, and all the other things that make, you know, conferences run. Our diamond sponsors are Microsoft, Target, Department of Homeland Security, Cybersecurity Service. Our platinum sponsors are Verizon, Amazon Security, Juniper Networks, MongoDB. Our gold sponsors are Remediant, Intel Security, Tynes, AWS, Toyota, Recorded Future. Our rainbow sponsors are Thermo Fisher Scientific, Information Networking Institute at Carnegie Mellon University, SYNAC, Google, Datadog, AFS, Red Siege, Dropbox, Brooks Animation. Our silver sponsors are Relativity, Bishop Fox, ICR. And our bronze sponsors is Cassio Security, ReSecurity, Tenable, G Research, Security Innovation, Bridge Crew, Mandiant, Security Risk Advisors, scope security, fractional CISO. Please take time to visit our sponsors that have all joined us in the hallway that you walk by here. The whole hallway is lined with them. Even though you may not need a job or their services just yet, they are lovely individuals. They have games, they have swag, and honestly, networking never hurts, right? We want to thank our CTF sponsors. Our CTF is hybrid, so you can either go over to our CTF room, which is literally right next door after the keynote, or you can join us virtually in the Discord channel. We want to thank our Career Village sponsors. You can head over to the Career Village, which is on the other side of us, after the keynote is done. They have resume reviews, mock interviews, but get there quick because sign up for those slots are going to go fast. Don't forget that the Career Village also has a panel talk. And we also want to make sure that everyone is aware that we actually have a job board this year. You can check that out online at tdi.mobi/jobboard, or you can head over to the Career Village. Right here is going to be our Career Village schedule. And then next to the Career Village, we actually have an interview room. Various sponsors are going to be holding career fairs, sessions where you can actually chat with not only the recruiting team, but the actual teams you'd be working on, so interface with them, see what their day's like, kind of thing. Be sure to check out the latest schedule that's going to be posted outside the door so you know who's going to be in there and what time. Lockpick Village. We have a lockpicking village that will be opening up after the keynote all the way around the corner with us. It is an in-person only event. So go ahead and check on over there, learn how locks work, and then how to bypass the locks. But we do have an after party. We have both. It is going to be for hybrid, and we're also going to end up having an in-person one. For the hybrid one, we have a list of games on our website that we suggest you kind of take a look at. They're free games, so anyone can go get and use them. Find groups, make new friends, play some fun games. For our after party for on-site, we're going to be flipping over our Maker Village, and it's going to start between 7 and 9 p.m. tonight. We have a bunch of board games, and we also have D&D, and it is going to be hosted by our own D&D master, Mr. Stoner. So come on over, adventure in the three-hour land of figuring out the mysteries and figuring out the eccentricities and adventures that he has got planned for you, because I have no idea, but I am really curious. We wanted to thank our Maker Village sponsors. Head on over to the Maker Village to learn new things and play with really all the blinky things. The Maker Village has workshops throughout the day, so keep checking through to see where you're at. And we also have supplies you need to assemble your DIY electronic badge, which will be a fun little game, which you can actually play Space Invaders on. If you purchased that, if you have not, you can still buy them online, and you can actually pick them up here. So we still have those available. We have, it looks like we have a couple workshops for Learn to Solder, a Stitch and Bitch hangout area, a sticker exchange, so if you like stickers, we got them. And we also have coloring pages. Our Maker Village is open from 9 to 5 each day. 10 to 11, we have a service-mounted device workshop on both days. And on August 11th, from 2 to 3 p.m., we have a beginning soldering workshop done by BuySight Lab. But if you forget to buy your service-mounted device for either of the workshops, you can buy them online and you can pick them up so you can actually attend that. And now, that you have sat here through all of this and me telling you and welcoming all of you, we will get to what you were all happily here and why you all joined us. So I will pass this off and we will get this started with our lovely opening.